Don Cayetan.
And Gloria Desiderio. And we are here to present the topic,
the Mesoarchean and Neoarchean era.
So we have here the Mesoarchean era. The Mesoarchean era is the era in the Archean Eon occurring after the Paleo-Archean era and the Neo-Archean era. There was a direct evidence of life. 2,000 to 2,800 million years ago, division of time to periods given. What happened during this time? Based on its geology, the oldest known glaciation event, Pongola, starts toward the end of this era. Pongola is a thick succession of Archean. It has supercrustal rocks and highly varied suite of clasts, some of which are striated and faceted. Extensive contamination events which have never been repeated in the earth in the history of the earth. The first supercontinent, Baalgara, broke up during this time. They call it supercontinent meaning a cluster nearly all continents. Supercontinent Europe may have originated during this time. Europe existed for a very long time, joining with other cratons to later form Bodinia and even later Pangaea. Europe is probably the continent on Earth billion years ago. It is the only continent. Bodinia was formed because Europe joined the continents Nena and Atlantica to form the supercontinent. Atmospheric oxygen. Atmospheric oxygen levels remain very low. As the oxygen continued to be used up in the oxidizing minerals, in the earth's crust and in the sea. The oldest known banded iron ore formation are from this time. Iron ores are rock from which metallic iron can be economically extracted. These rocks are usually found in the form of hematite and magnetite. Evidence for chemical weathering of rocks leading to soil formation that occurred in the presence of oxygen at least 3.02 billion years ago. Free oxygen present in the oceans, possibly formed from cyanobacteria around 3.2 billion years ago. Also known, cyanobacteria, also known as cyanophyta, it's a phylum of bacteria that obtain their energy through photosynthesis. The name cyanobacteria comes from the color of the bacteria, which is blue. So here's the example of iron ore. And this is the example of cell structure of cyanobacteria. The color of these pigments gives cyanobacteria the common name blue-green algae. But remember, the cyanobacteria are not true algae. So based on its biology, anaerobic prokaryotes, diversification of stromatolites on Earth, potentially complex composite of phytoplankton. So this is the example of stromatolites at Lake Mead, Western Australia. Stromatolites are layered mounds, columns, and sheet-like sedimentary rocks. They were originally formed by the growth layer upon cyanobacteria. Single code photosynthesizing microbe that lives today in a wide range of environments ranging from the shallow shell lakes, rivers, and even soils. So this is the example from Hamelin Pool, Western Australia. Fossils from Australia show that stromatolites have lived on Earth since the Mesoarchean.
The Neoarchean is the fourth and final era in the Archaic Eon, occurring after the Mesoarchean era and before the Paleo-Proterozoic era. The Neoarchean era is the beginning of oxygen forming. Its age is 2,800 to 2,500 million years ago. Division of time, no periods taken. What happened during this time? Based on geology, continents as we know today, with continental plates and plate tectonics appeared. Subduction zones, continental plates sliding over each other, and the welling of lava to produce new crust where continental plates tore apart. Continents grow by getting lighter and tougher. Cyclic their melting and their formation of rock through lava flows gradually separates the lighter minerals and allows the development of felsic rocks from massive rocks. Lighter rocks are more buoyant and resist recycling by floating over the liquid mantle. The supercontinent Catalan formed during the beginning of this period. So this is the map of the Catalan supercontinent. Based on biology, evidence for the origin of oxygen-forming photosynthesis. Cyanobacteria probably use manganese as an electric source. Prokaryotic microbes may have been present on land as early as 2.75 million years ago. Prokaryotic means a microscopic single-cell organism that has neither a distinct nucleus with a membrane nor specialized organs. Sulfur and molybdenum levels increased in the oceans around this time. The simultaneous increase of both indicates that microbes on land may have been breaking down rock which washed into the sea. Microbes are bacterium-causing disease or fermentation.
To summarize everything, the conditions during the Mesoarchean era was that their geologies, supercontinents, broke up and then formed new ones, which later turned into forming new supercontinents in the future. And then their dominant species were mostly bacteria, cyanobacteria, microbes, and fungi, and others. Their found fossils was stromatolites, which were mostly discovered in the Western Australia part, which means that they have aged long and that they've lived since the Mesoarchean era. During the Neoarchean era, their conditions were mostly the continents, the plate tectonics appeared and they formed the surface already during this time. They produced a new crust for continental plates for us. And then some of their dominant species were the forming of photosynthesis and also the increase in the level of sulfur and molybdenum, which is needed for animal life. And so that's all we have to say about the Mesoarchean and the Neoarchean era. We hope it was informative.
Thank you for listening. We hope that you learned something new.
It's all about